So we had seen, if we find that I have put 70 gram of NaCl in 1.5 liters, the solution volume after putting NaCl, if that is 1.5 liters, then the number of moles, this is the number of moles of NaCl, isn't it? This is the number of moles of NaCl, that divided by the volume in liters, so that gives me 0.80 molarity. It's not mole, okay? We call it 0.80 molar solution, okay? It will be written either 0.80 capital M or if someone writes 0.80 molar, M-O-L-A-R, molar solution, okay? So 5 gram of, calculate the molarity of 5 gram of NaOH in 450 ml of solution, okay? So there's a question, find the molarity of, find the molarity if 5 gram of NaOH is present in 450 ml of the solution. So we'll first find the gram molecular mass of NaOH. NaOH molecular weight of NaOH is equal to 23 plus 16 plus, what is the molecular mass of this?
23
hydrogen. What is the mass of hydrogen? Pratik? Why one? Because it has no neutron. Protium has no neutron, right? Then deuterium has, tritium has. Fine. So molecular mass is, this is actually gram molecular mass, right? So gram molecular mass is so much. So number of moles in 5 grams. That'll be, see, I write it like that. 5 gram equals 1 mole. Sorry. 40 grams equals 1 mole. 1 gram equals 1 by 40 mole. 5 gram equals 1 by 40 into 5. So 5 upon 40. So that is 1 upon 8, which is 0.125 moles. Correct? Now what? 450 ml is how much in liters? How many liters is that? Milli is what? Milli is an exponent that is 10 to the power minus 3, always. So you call it milliliter, you call it milligram, you call it millimeter, okay? It means 10 to the power minus 3, whatever. So it is 450, this is 450, this is milli, and this is liter, okay? So this is actually 0.45 liters, right? So what is the molarity? Molarity M is equal to 0.125 divided by 0.45. So that gives you, if I multiply it by 1000, I get 125 upon 450, 5 upon 18 is how much? 0.2, 14, 7, 126, 14, 14 and again, so 7, no? It will keep on repeating, isn't it? 0.277, it will go like that, correct? So if we round it off, it gives you 0.28 molar, okay? That is 0.28 M. We understand? Do we get that? That is mole per liter, no? What is the unit of this? This is mole per liter, and it is that mole per liter that you decide to call M.
So if
DM, what is that?
Decimeter.
Oh, that is per decimeter cube. Yeah, DM, decimeter, see, what is your, liter is unit of volume, right? Liter is unit of volume. So they must have written 0.28 mole per liter, or they have written 0.28 mole per decimeter cube. Okay. Now liter, which is a unit of volume, is how much? 1 liter is 1 meter cube. You understand? Now 1,000 liter is equal to 1 meter cube. What does that mean? It means that in a cuboid that is 1 meter by 1 meter by 1 meter, I can put 1,000 liters. Okay. Now if you see, 1 liter will be equal to 1 divided by 1,000. Okay. 1 divided by 1,000 meter cube. Correct. Now, what is that? Meter cube. Now, if I decide to convert this meter cube into, say, centimeter, so what happens? 1 meter, we understand one thing, that this is nothing but this meter cube means 1 meter multiplied by 1 meter multiplied by another 1 meter, that divided by 1,000. Correct. Now what is that equal to? 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So it is 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter upon 1,000. Now what is that equal to? What is that equal to? This is equal to
1,000.
Do I erase this? The one you have already done. So here I am clearing this much. Fine. So that is equal to 1,000, no? So there are 6 zeros in the numerator, there are only 3 in the denominator, 3 get cancelled. So I am left with 1,000 centimeter cube, which can be said to be 10 centimeter into 10 centimeter into 10 centimeter. Now try to understand. That means if you take a plastic sheet, perspex sheets, the transparent sheets, okay, and you make a cuboid of 10 centimeter, which is this much, by 10, that is exactly 1 liter. Okay,
the volume will be
1 liter. 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter of a vessel will hold exactly 1 liter. So you can make your own measure at home. Fine. Now 10 centimeter, okay, so what is 10 centimeter equal to? 1 decimeter. 10 centimeter is 1 decimeter. So this is equal to 1 decimeter cube. Decimeter is something that is normally not used, so we are not so accustomed to it. But if you remember, maybe in your some class 3, 4, 5, I don't know where, they must have introduced you to this concept. Milli, centi, deci, meter,
deca,
hecta, hecta, kilo, meter. Milli, centi, decimeter, deca, hecta, kilometer, right? This was kind of the rhyme that we were taught to remember it. And each will be, the next one is actually the yeah, 10 times the earlier one. So 10 mm will be 1 cm, 10 cm will be 1 dm, 10 dm will be 1 meter, and 10 meter will be 1 deca, 10 deca will be 1 hecta, 10 hecta will be 1 kilo. Okay, all get multiplied by 10. So this into 10 gives me this. Okay, into 10 gives me this. So if I want to jump from here to here, 10 into 10, 100. 100 mm is 1 decimeter. Correct. So instead of writing liter, we can also write decimeter cube, and decimeter is nothing but 10 centimeter. You should always keep that in mind. It is a very, very, very important concept.